Our episode is based on a short story by John Scalzi. It's about a character who's trapped in her own house with her vacuum boat going crazy and dealing with a stupid customer service on the phone.
So, are you willing to throw your pet at the vacuum bot?
What we really liked about John's story was the opportunity to tackle this classic sci-fi theme of machines' rebellion against human from an original and quirky angle. The material was very minimalist, which was great because it gave us a lot of space to create the universe and the characters. So Sunset City is very much inspired by the retirement communities you can find in Florida or Arizona, but set in the near future. Our characters are very old, tired, and totally dependent on technology. So they're basically the least ready for a fight against robots. Same for the vacuum bot. We're not dealing with an intelligent and evil AI machine rebelling against its creators. We're dealing with the most stupid machine you can think of, which is a vacuum cleaner.
Character design is a very important step. We wanted to feel the satirical spirit of the short story in the design.
The current wait time is 6 hours and 14 minutes.
Seriously.
Old people are a great source of inspiration for us. It was really fun to design the characters, trying to make them both grotesque and sympathetic, especially Jeanette. It took us a little while to find the right look. We needed to feel empathy for her.
Hi. Once we're happy with the 2D designs, the next step is to interpret them in 3D and put the character in flesh. In that process, the idea was to get the feeling of a little puppet in a dollhouse. We also use the character design to emphasize the contrast between human and robot. As opposed to the elder, very organic and fleshy, we wanted a very sleek and minimalist design for the robot. One of the challenges of the film was to give life and personality to this simple cube. That's what's great about Love, Death and Robots. Every artist is able to develop his own style. And it's like a chocolate box, you know? There is chocolate for every taste. If you don't like one, you can keep it for your old uncle.